So when the humid shadows hover over all the starry spheres, and the melancholy darkness gently weeps in rainy dews, what a bliss to press the pillow of a cottage chamber bed and lie listening to the patter of the soft rain overhead. Every tinkle on the shingles, has an echo in the heart and a thousand dreamy fancies into busy being start. And a thousand recollections weave their air threads into woof as I listen to the patter of the rain upon the roof. Now in memory lanes comes my mother, as she used in years ago to regard the darling dreamers ere she left them till the dawn. Oh, I feel her fond look on me as I list to this refrain which is played upon the shingles by the patter of the rain. So I don't say that you might have understood the whole poem 100%, but try to answer my questions in brief, maybe in yes or no. Is the poet happy in the poem? Is it about happy mood of the poet? How many of you say yes, ma'am? Poet is very happy. Yes. Is the poet happy in the poem? Is it about happy mood of the poet? Let me repeat a few lines. From there you make out, is the poet happy or not? I will ask anyone. Okay? Maybe he's happy, maybe he's not, I don't know yet. But I am expecting this answer from you all. Okay? Such great. All ears. Give me all ears. You also such great. Close this book. Keep this in your bag. And you also sit straight. You need not show book to anyone. All of them can listen to me. Okay? They are very attentive children. So in order to get answer from you whether the poet is happy or not, I'm giving you a few lines especially. And the melancholy darkness gently weeps in rainy tears. Now other lines. Now in memory comes my mother, as she used in years agone to regard the darling dreamers ere she left them till the dawn. Oh, I feel her fond look on me as I listen to this song refrain, which is played upon the shingles by the patter of the rain. So in order to answer my question, whether the poet is happy or not, you try to give answer to the question, is the poet's mother alive? Yeah, it states very clearly the last stanza that his mother died many years ago, and now whenever it rains, he is reminded of his mother. His mother comes to his dreams or his memories. Okay, his mother comes back. He's reminded of his mother when it rains. So when somebody remembers somebody who is no more with one, you cannot say that person is happy. That person is seeking solace, thereby remembering that person. But basically, the person is missing that person. So when somebody misses somebody, one is not happy. And moreover, in the very beginning, the poet says, which I spoke the lines, and the melancholy darkness gently weeps in rainy tears. What does it mean? What is melancholy? Melancholic word you might have heard many a times. Melancholy is sad. Melancholy darkness gently weeps in tears. How can darkness be? In the darkness, when it is night, then it rains. And the poet is only comparing as if the darkness, he's comparing darkness with rain. And the rain is like the tears of that darkness, of that night. When it rains, the poet feels as if it is the tear of night. Night or darkness, the same thing. So why is the night crying? Because the night is dark, dark with sadness. But basically, it's not the night which is sad. It's the poet who is sad. And he feels as if his sadness is being reflected through the rain. He imagines as if those are the tears falling from the heaven. As if the nature is also shedding its sadness through rain. As if the nature is sharing his sadness. So the mood of the poet is sad. Reasons, very clear reason is he misses his mother. Got it? Now, second question, very simple question. Is the poet a child? No. The poet seems to be adult. He seems to be quite a grown-up person. But even then, he remembers his mother. When his mother used to make him to sleep when he was a child. And at that time, was the poet alone as a child or somebody else was with him? Was he alone as a child? Okay, his mother and poet. Were these two people were there or somebody else was also there? Alone? How can you say? There is a hint in the poem from where we come to know that the poet also... Yes. There is a hint in the poem that he had some brothers and sisters, that is siblings. And the mother used to make them to sleep. And who those siblings would be there and mother would make them all sleep. Mother would love them a lot. And for mother, all children are her darlings. Okay, somebody whom you love. So mother put darling dreamers to sleep. So there is an expression in the poem, see that? So she used in years agone to regard the darling dreamers. Who are the darling dreamers?
His siblings.
He and his siblings. So mother used to consider them as the darling and she would make them to sleep. And in the sleep, they would be. So there is a reference to the time when the poet was a small child and his mother used to love him and his other siblings a lot. And their mother used to make them sleep. So, with her lullabies or whatever. So mother lovingly would make them sleep. And that time the poet is missing right now. So as an adult right now, his siblings might have gone somewhere else. Okay, the whole family doesn't remain at one place when children grow up. So he is missing his mother and he is missing his siblings also. But basically his mother. So what makes him remember all this? Rain. And when does rain? When does it rain? At night. At night when otherwise there is pin drop silence all around. And then when it rains and you are sleeping in your bedroom and when you are lying on your couch, thereby taking a very cozy pillow, then when it rains on the rooftop, then that pitter patter sound, that is very pleasing basically. But yes, if somebody is some near and dear one is not with him or her, then that person also remembers that person because rain, if it brings happiness, spring and all, then rain also brings back the memories of happiness. So this is true with the poet also, right? So this is the context of the poem. And the poem has been written very beautifully. Simple idea, simple, if I tell you the storyline of the poem is that the poet says that when it is night, when it is complete dark all around, then it rains, and at the time it appears as if the clouds have covered up the whole sky, and when they fall upon these shingles, means the tiles on the roof, when the raindrops fall on the tiles of the rooftop and create the pitter patter sound, then he is reminded of his mother, of the times when his mother used to make them sleep very lovingly or very caringly. So this time, this rain makes him remember mother. That's it. Only this small idea the poet has written in three beautiful stanzas, and this poem is interspersed with so many poetic devices. So when you are going to read the poem, then you also see how the poem is written, what kind of things are kept in mind, just not rhyming scheme. When we people write a poem, what we see, we just bother for a rhyme scheme. But it's not just the rhyme scheme. There are so many other things which go in for the making of a beautiful poem. And what are those things? I'm just going to write a few poetic devices over here, and you people try to identify if they are there. So when they come, you will tell me, ma'am, yes, it is here. But not in between. First, I'll be explaining the poem from a very simple point of view. Then in the end, we'll be discussing the poetic devices within 3 or 4 minutes. If something would be left, then on Tuesday, I mean next week. Okay, I might send you a small message containing the poetic devices where they would be explained. So the poetic devices, the poem is interspersed with, number one, the basic poetic devices, alliteration. So alliteration is the repetition of the consonant sound in one line. Okay, it's the repetition of the consonant sound. For example, busy bee. I'm just giving you an example over here. Here, busy bee. Here, bur sound is repeated. B is a consonant sound. So where in two consecutive or in a line, the consonant sounds are repeated, we say that the poet has used alliteration as a poetic device. And there are many more examples of alliteration in the poem. You will be finding it yourself if I don't get the time right now. Second, very important poetic device the poet is talking about is personification. Personification is giving non-living things the attributes of a living thing. Making non-living things look like living. So what's the poetic device over here? Personification. And the personification is here in the form of anyone?
Gently
yes. Weeps. What weeps? Rain. So it is a starry sphere gently weeps in rainy tears. Okay, I'm just giving you one example. There are more examples of personification. Then very important other poetic device which is there, that is?
Enjambment.
Transferred epithet. This is, I guess, new for you people. Transferred epithet is it. Epithet means adjective. What's the meaning of epithet? Adjective. So transferred epithet means the poetic device where an adjective refers to a noun. It refers to one noun, but actually it should refer to something else. For example, over here.
Melancholy
darkness. Yeah. Melancholy. Darkness. What's the meaning of melancholy?
Sad.
And melancholy is adjective. Mind it. Listen. When you talk in between just Karan, then you miss the concept. What do you want to miss? Talk or concept? So it's right. Get to the side. This side. So I'm telling you, like, transferred epithet is an adjective which refers to a noun
other than the one which is implied here. Here, melancholy is adjective, right? Melancholy means sad. Who is sad? Human beings are sad, right? But here it says melancholy darkness. Can darkness be sad? Darkness cannot be sad. Darkness is not a human being. So melancholy should refer to human being, but here it says darkness. So this is transferred. So in a way, rain dispels the sadness of human beings. Got it? I'll explain all these things. But you just try to understand here, adjective is referring to a noun, and it should not refer to this noun. It should refer to some other noun, and that other noun we know is human being. So here, melancholy darkness is an example of transferred epithet. This transferred epithet is a poetic device which is used by the poets to make the poems become symbolic. It makes the poems beautiful in that sense. Right? If the poet also says that melancholy man, melancholy poet, melancholy me, it won't make that great effect. So melancholy darkness. So the darkness which is sad. How can the darkness be sad? Because it is crying. How can you say that the darkness is crying? Because it is raining in the night. What if, so that expression the poet is giving here. Okay, transferred epithet is there. Then there would be? Enchantment is there?
Yes.
So, enchantment is a poetic device where the poet switches over to next line without using punctuation marks. Okay, what is enchantment? Where a poet switches over to the next line without a full stop, comma, colon, semicolon, anything. Punctuation. Okay, just not one sign. Okay, so there are some lines in the poem where there is no punctuation. So the poet has effectively used enchantment also there. Right? So for solidification, alliteration, enchantment, so there are more poetic devices.
Metaphor,
I don't see. Sometimes people confuse personification with metaphor also. So that way we might see. So very important poetic device otherwise is onomatopoeia. Onomatopoeia is, do you know what is it? Onomatopoeia is the sound. It's a sound word. What is onomatopoeia?
Sound.
It's a sound word itself. When somebody falls, that is not say somebody. When something falls, it creates a sound. And we don't know what sound. We call it, it fell with a thud. The sound which comes finally is thud. Okay, when the horse gallops, it creates some sound.
Plot, plot, plot.
That sound is a word. T-N-O-T. Okay, when you play with tennis, your racket, strikes that shuttle and the sound comes up. So that sound is called as onomatopoeic. Mind it, listen. Onomatopoeic word is the sound word. That's it. When a snake hisses, that's a sound is onomatopoeic. In this poem, find out which word is onomatopoeic. So when it rains, and when you would listen to it very silently, with a focus, then you will see that yes, it is somewhat patter. Okay, pitter, patter. There is a rhythm in it. Okay, so hiss, this is onomatopoeia. Bang, onomatopoeia. Okay, so the sound words are onomatopoeic. And the poet has very effectively used onomatopoeic words. And moreover, onomatopoeic words also give auditory image. What do they give? Auditory image. What is auditory? Which can be heard.
The moment you say bank, you feel as if something has banged into your ears. Okay, so something which gives you a feeling of listening something, but actually you don't listen. But you feel as if you listened something, you call it an auditory imagery. So the purpose of using onomatopoeic is also to give auditory imagery by the poet. You can also write auditory imagery. How many kinds of imageries are there? Three? Let me tell you, one is visual imagery, what you perceive. Listen better, these are very serious things. There is nothing humorous. And when humorous something will be there, I'll tell you that you have. Again, you people did not tell me one. Got it? Yes, very nice.
We'll revise
the poem on Monday.
Wednesday. Thursday. On Thursday, we'll revise. Okay. Why Thursday? Thursday. We'll revise on Thursday. Okay. Yes. We have a period on all days. Okay. Tiny tots, small children, you know, they need to be told again and again, like, better listen, I'm teaching you something. Small children are to be given a reminder, better I am teaching you something. So those who are the tiny tots here, they raise hand. Raise hand, those who are the tiny tots. We can send them to KG Wing. Seats are vacant. Stand up, you third bench. Stand up. Want to go to nursery wing? Sit. Others will not speak. The one who speaks for no reason is a tiny tot. And you need not tell me whether you are. I am able to make out. Okay, sometimes some people grow up physically, but mentally they are there only. So grow up mentally also. Grow up intellectually also. I told 10 times to sit straight. And sitting straight means that your other arm should also be on your desk. And when I say something, I mean it. If I'm saying I may send you to nursery wing, I will. Ta-da. Listen carefully. Now in between, I don't want any disturbance. Sit down, please. Yes, yes. And come back silently. Okay, look at the text now. And when you come, sit here only, beta, you go to that side. You go to that side, come on. Okay. When the humid showers hover over all the starry spheres and the melancholy darkness gently weeps in rainy tears, what a bliss to press the pillow of a cottage chamber bed and lie listening to the patter of the soft rain overhead. Humid means moisture. Right? Shadows is something which is dark. But here, humid shadows refer to the clouds, because clouds are dark when they are full of water. So when the dark clouds, which are full of water, when they hover, when they move about the starry spheres, what are the starry spheres? Sky. Starry spheres refer to sky. And humid shadows refer to clouds, dark clouds full of water. When the dark clouds, which are full of water, move about the sky and And the melancholy darkness gently weeps in rainy tears. So when the dark clouds move over the sky, when they flint across the sky, then the darkness, which otherwise seemed to be very sad, because darkness cannot be happy. The darkness, sad darkness, seems to be crying when it rains. When the dark clouds cover the sky, and when it starts raining, it appears as if the sadness has been dispelled by the rain drops, as if the rain has cleared off, as if the rain has wiped off sadness. So stand up, you second girl. Yeah. So what does it mean when I say, I'll be repeating, then I ask you one question. So when the clouds flint across the sky, it starts raining. And the rain seems to drive off the sadness from the earth. Clear? What a bliss to press the pillow of a cottage chamber bed. Here, cottage chamber bed is the bedroom only. So then, when it rains at night, then it's a blessing. It's a heaven to listen to the sound of the raindrops falling on the rooftop. What a bliss. What a bliss means, it's really a heavenly kind of situation or a feeling. It's a blessing to listen to the pitter patter sound of the rain drops falling on the rooftop when you are lying so peacefully in your bedroom, right? So when you're lying peacefully on a cozy bed in your bedroom, and then when it starts raining and you're able to listen to the pitter patter sound on the rooftop, then nothing can be better than that. Got it? Bell has gone, huh? Yes, children, this poem, as much comes, if you are able to tackle, do that. The rest we'll do later on. Okay?